What does a person experiencing post-polio conditions look like? That's an interesting question with a surprising answer. Looking at someone or at how they move does not tell us much about someone's polio exposure. In Australia, this person is likely to be an adult, but they could be an adult of any age. They could be of any ethnicity and of any gender. Even an experienced doctor could not identify if a person was exposed to polio just by looking at them. This is because the symptoms experienced by those who have post-polio conditions are quite variable, and some symptoms are visible and some are not. Remember that paralysis and any resulting movement deviations are one visible sign of exposure to polio. Only 1% of those exposed to polio developed paralysis that was detected by their doctors, and many of these had quite remarkable recoveries. Another 8% who had virus symptoms but who had no sign to paralysis are also at risk for developing post-polio conditions later in life. There are many people who were exposed to polio and who have late effect symptoms who could walk into a room, sit down, get up, move around, and look just like someone who didn't experience polio. There would be no clear indication that they were having post-polio symptoms. They may have invisible symptoms that can only be observed or experienced under certain conditions. For example, they may get tired very quickly doing chores around the house. They may only be able to walk a few hundred meters before they feel weak and need to rest or to use a walking device. They might have pain that increases during the day, making everything more difficult to do in the afternoon. These things you would not see unless you spent a lot of time with them. When using health services, symmetrically presenting people who identify as polio survivors get frustrated when clinicians assume that they can do what others who look similar to them can do. But this is like assuming that every parked car you see operates the same way and has the same amount of fuel in the tank. Some physical signs may suggest, but not confirm, that someone had polio, because they are more commonly seen with those who had paralysis from polio. Physical signs such as using a built-up shoe on one side, or wearing a long leg brace, or having difficulty using an arm or a leg symmetrically. It is important to remember that people with a history of polio may or may not identify strongly with having had polio. They may or may not wish to share their polio experience, and they may or may not have connections with others who share a similar life experience. We should not assume that these people want to be identified as such. They are trying to live their best lives just like everybody else, and their medical histories are their own business. What can you do to appreciate there are people experiencing difficulties you can't see? Be aware that those who were ill with polio are probably living in your community, and many of them don't have a visible disability. If you encounter someone who is open to talking about their polio experience, then talk with them about it. You will learn a lot. If you work in healthcare, take a look at your new client information form questions. Are there any questions on yours that would prompt someone to declare a history of polio, knowing that they are not easy to recognize otherwise? Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. By understanding post-polio topics, you are helping to improve health outcomes. Visit Polio Australia's website for further information and to download resources.